Hello friends, welcome to my channel Maths Tips for You. In my last video, we have seen converse, inverse and contrapositive of an implication and its example. Some of the example were left as exercise for you. That will be covered in this video. If you are not still watched that video, please watch that video before watching this video. In this video, we are going to learn what is meant by tautology, contradiction, and contingency, and their examples. First, we shall see tautology, denoted by small t. A statement pattern which is true for all the combinations of the truth values of the its component statement is called tautology. Example, P or negation of P. We shall see the truth table of P or negation of P. We observe that last column contains only T. Next is contradiction, denoted by small c. A statement pattern which is false for all the combinations of the truth values of its component statement is called contradiction. Example, P and negation of P. From truth table we observe that the last columns contains only F. It is obvious that the negation of a tautology is a contradiction and vice versa. Now we shall see contingency. A statement pattern which is neither a tautology nor a contradiction is called contingency. Example, P or Q. We shall see the truth table of P or Q. We observe that the last column is the combination of T and F. Example, determine whether the following statement pattern is a tautology or a contradiction or contingency. 1. Negation of P or Q implies P and Q or negation of Q. We shall see the truth table. From the truth table, we observe that the last column of the above truth table neither all T nor all F. Therefore, the given statement is neither tautology nor a contradiction. It is contingency. Now we shall see exercise from my last video on converse, inverse and contrapositive. Example number 1. Write the converse, inverse and contrapositive of an implication. Number 2. A family becomes literate if the women in it are literate. Solution. Rewriting the given statement by using if then. If the women in the family are literate, then the family becomes literate. Let P denote the women in the family are literate and Q denote a family become literate. Its symbolic form is P implies Q. A. Its converse is Q implies P. That is, if a family become literate, then the women in it are literate. B. Its inverse is negation of P implies negation of Q. That is, if the women in the family are not prepared, then family does not become prepared. C. Its contrapositive is negation of Q implies negation of P. That is, if a family does not become literate, then the women in it are not literate. Example number 2. Consider following statement. Identify the pair of statements having same meaning. Solution. Let P denote a person is social and Q denote a person is happy. Then their symbolic forms are. We know that from my last video on converse, inverse and contrapositive, implication and contrapositive are same. Therefore, A and C are same. And inverse and converse are same. Therefore, B and D are same. Example 3. Rewrite the following statement without using the conditional form. 2. If it is cold, we wear woolen clothes. 3. I can catch cold if I take cold water bath. Solution. Number 2. Let P denote it is cold, Q denote we wear woolen cloth. Its symbolic form is P implies Q. We know that P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation of P or Q. Therefore, negation of P or Q is the statement without the conditional form. That is, it is not cold or we wear woolen cloth. Third, rewriting above statement as if I take cold water bath, then I can catch cold. P denote I take cold water bath, Q denote I can catch cold. Its symbolic form is P implies Q, and as above, P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation of P or Q. Then the statement without conditional is I do not take cold water bath or I can catch cold. In this way, we have seen tautology, contradiction and contingency and their examples. In my next video, we are going to learn what is meant by quantifiers and quantified statements. Thanking you.